The Africa Trade Link and Expo was inaugurated on July 24, 2014 at the Kenyatta International Conference Center in the bustling Central Business District of Nairobi, Kenya. This three-day conference was the culmination of the intentions, collaboration, and resources of several African Americans that first began meeting several years prior to this milestone event. Several hundred business professionals and entrepreneurs from all over Kenya and East Africa attended. They were enthusiastically received by an inspired delegation from America, unified in the shared vision of creating partnerships of mutual prosperity between America and Africa in spirit of peace and friendship. The Africa Trade Link and Expo, ATLE, is sponsored by an organization of the same name. ATLE is a California nonprofit corporation that was founded in the summer of 2013 by Judy Minaj. Ms. Minaj is a successful entrepreneur who is originally from Kenya. Although she is now a U.S. citizen, having lived in America for over 25 years, she never lost touch with her country of origin. Prior to initiating the founding of ATLE, Judy had successfully created her own trade missions to Kenya within her line of business, women's clothes, which were highly profitable. Collaboration with like-minded individuals inspired a greater vision that would provide more diverse opportunities for both American and African businesses. Tyrone Hooks is also someone who is connected to Kenya. Although Tyrone is born in America, he attended university in Nairobi during his college years. Tyrone is intimately connected to the culture and has a great interest in seeing Kenya prosper both economically and socially. Along with his colleagues, Benjamin Walker and Dr. Chipasha Luchembe, they formed the nucleus of the nonprofit organization African Business and Culture Development, ABCD. Through the coming together of ABCD with Judy Minaj, the foundation was laid for something that would be a labor of love and provide the inspiration for others to join in the intention. Beginning in 2013, this initial core group connected with John Brown of the Bedford Group of Companies. John was in a position to provide a suitable meeting place whereby the planning and other related activities necessary to bring this opportunity forward would be realized. It is truly a blessing when others are able to share in a sacred vision. It is rare, however, for a new venture to receive funding from outside sources, i.e. corporate sponsors, philanthropic organizations, or individuals. For ATLE, it was necessary for individuals to step forth to make it happen. These individuals mentioned, along with others, did step forth and made the commitments, financial, time, labor, and talent, to ensure the success of the first annual trade mission. This is only the beginning. Our vision for the Africa Trade Link Expo is that it will be an annual conference and that many more will partner with us on this sacred journey, which includes so much more than simply a conference. We look forward to your commitment and participation. And in the words of our inaugural host country's national language, Swahili, Asante sana. Thank you very much. Toka kuimba na kitambulisho misina nimepoteza wale na sijachukua nyingine na sijakata kosa nililofanya sijakata kitambulisho sina.
Sangazela, ngeni nyonga yo. system which I'm going to explain to you how we can get it to you, but that system basically starts from the soil to plant to the newest technology to animals to you human being back in the soil without leaving behind any carbon traces. Basically what I'm saying, you can use your land to produce a certain crop. You can manufacture that crop, turn it into ethanol, give to your friends who have cars, rich friends, to use it in their cars. You can take the leftovers, feed your chickens, your pigs, turn it into meat, sell it to Kenya meat, sell it to your neighbors. Feed some to yourself and be able to export some abroad to the Americans, the Europeans, the Russians, to the Chinese.
The solutions are not always coming from government or some business telling the people what it is that they need to do. Really, all we might need to do is free the people enough so that they can find that those solutions are already in them, and that individual responsibility becomes a collective responsibility, becomes a cultural legacy and a social legacy for creating economic justice, something that needs to happen here and something that also needs to happen in Los Angeles.
So SS Ventures Group, my firm, a consulting firm engaged in business strategy, business development, marketing, digital media. I think there's a misnomer out there that sometimes you can just put a website up, or you can put a Facebook page up, or you can sign up to a Twitter account, and you've got a business, and all of a sudden now your business is going to be successful. So I want to kind of delve into that and say to you that it is a tool, but it is not going to be the key to your success. It takes strategy. It takes a business plan, basically, which includes an idea, a vision, and a mission of what your business is. Who is your target audience? Who are you trying to reach? And what tools are you using to reach them? Various advertising, sales strategies, e-marketing, digital media, and social media. Someone who's skilled in these areas can help you synchronize this activity to give you a productive outcome.
Speaking on behalf of the Kenyan business community, and I want to give you a brief history, my friendship with the US. I was heading the Department of Small and Medium Enterprise as from 1998 in the Chamber of Commerce, and I think my continuous expression and the passion that I had and the understanding that I had about the strength of the SME in sustaining a country economy, I was the first person that benefited from the US Embassy support to come to US and have my first meeting with the head of African, Sub-Saharan African SME department in the World Bank, Mr. Ian Crest. And I came as a state visit. I was received in US, taken around for various meetings, Exim Bank. And I had a very fruitful meeting with Ian Crest, who was the head of Sub-Saharan Africa on SME matters in the World Bank. I was surprised when I went there. I saw several newspaper cutting where they used to pick me when I'm talking about SME. And by that time, in this country, nobody understand what is this SME this guy used to talk about. We didn't have any policy, we didn't have any law that governed us. So we are operating in a very good way. But to date, everybody wants to associate with it because of its stability in sustaining the country economy.
Most small businesses in Kenya, small businesses in America, they don't have the capital to fly back and forth to develop what's necessary to do business. And that's an initial relationship. So through ATL, we want to help that process. Our expectations here, I didn't come here for my health. I came here to sign some deals. So I'm looking for a Kenyan partner that will team with us and look after growing opportunities to provide these various counties with solar systems, solar farms. What we're going to do, what I'm planning on doing with my Kenyan partner, is to select one county, go to Joy and get the money, and establish that county as a standard for standardization in Kenya. But we need to do the first deal. And it's very important for me to select the right Kenyan partner. SMEs are the number one job creators in the world. SMEs are the backbone of all economies, whether they're developed, undeveloped, or developing. So in Kenya, it's very important for us to develop the SME marketplace for jobs and a quality of life. First of all, a little history on WEI. We started about 1981 as a manufacturer. We migrated into distribution, and we found an area in power where we could support or provide products for the electrical grid in the U.S. So we became a distributor. So we distribute products that basically supported the grid. Everyone needs power. So it was an opportunity for us. So what we want to do is the same thing in Kenya. We're looking for a Kenyan partner to be a distributor. We want you to become our master distributor in one county in Kenya and set up sub-distributors in other counties and work directly with end users. And we both benefit. The other products we distribute are prefab steel buildings, HVAC systems, and heavy-duty construction rental equipment. The first partner was a distributor. The second partner, we need a solar integrator here. A solar company that can do design, engineering, product sourcing, installation, training. Can do all of what's necessary to satisfy the customer on this end. And we'll provide with that, with the company here, engineering support in the U.S. And then we'll go to the WEI side and get that particular distributor to provide them with all the components that they need to complete or to build their solar farms. So it creates a win-win opportunity for both companies.
Good morning again. My name is Joy Elliott. I'm from Los Angeles, California, recently moved to the Inland Empire. And what I want to talk to you about today is EB-5, which is a government program of the United States for people to make an investment from foreign countries and receive their green card. So I'm going to talk very, very briefly about the program, just give you some basic information and see if it sounds interesting enough to you to get additional information about it. So what is the definition of EB-5? It basically stands for Employment-Based Preference 5. It's just a name that the United States has given to this program. So there's hundreds of types of visas that you can get to go to any country. The U.S. has also hundreds, and one of them is called EB-5. It was created in 1990, so a really long time ago, and thousands of people have come to the U.S. through this program. And what it is basically you make an investment into a U.S. business, one that's there, existing already, one that you create, or if you have businesses here, you can expand your business over there and also receive this green card. It's very flexible. It's probably the fastest way right now to get into the United States. I spoke with some people. We had a mixer last night and we spoke with some people. This gentleman had the funds in order to go to the United States, but it took him 6 years to get his green card. But if he had gone through this program, it probably would have taken 6 months, maybe a year. So what we're doing at Four Seasons Development is that we are providing consultation to people. We're providing matching to existing businesses that could use these funds. And then we're also providing services when you do decide to immigrate, or you, if you decide to move to the United States through this program, we will hold you by the hand and give you advice on how to access different kinds of services in addition to help running your business. One of the great things, though, that you'll see later in the presentation is that you don't actually have to emigrate to the United States through this program. You can actually live abroad or in the country of origin. So the minimum investment for this program is $1 million, $1 million US dollars, and if it's not in a targeted area. Now, targeted area just basically means that it's a low income area or it's high unemployment. So you guys are familiar with high unemployment as well. And we have high unemployment, especially in ethnic neighborhoods, black neighborhoods, Latin neighborhoods, in the United States. And so what the US has said is that if you decide to invest in one of those, your minimum investment goes down to $500,000. But that's just the minimum. Sometimes we have business opportunities that are so great that people decide to invest more than that, and it makes sense for them to do that. The other thing that I want to point out that for it's a job creation program, which is why the US put the program in place in the first place. And so for every investor, that investment is responsible for the creation of 10 jobs minimum, okay? So it's really a win-win situation. You get a chance to invest in a business, to realize all the returns and benefits of owning a business in the United States, but you're also helping the economic development of the community.
I'm John Brown. I spend a normal work day for me is to go into my office and work on real estate development deals. Now, I've reached an age where I don't do that every day. So real estate development, and watch how this follows any business. Real estate development is land, concept, what am I going to do with it? Feasibility. Is what I want to do feasible? You know, will people buy it? Or will they rent it? Or will they buy there? Can I finance it? Will it make enough money to pay off my investors and pay off my bank loan? So, you know, we all got ideas, but are they feasible? And then the market takes over from there. When I finish, do the market like my product? Will it buy it? Will it rent it and pay the rent I want? Will it pay, you know, will it do the project? Now notice, that works for any business that you're in. We all have ideas, but have we really sit down and done the work to make sure it's feasible? Some of us are even in business, and what we're doing will never accomplish what we want because we haven't done the homework. We haven't done the research to determine the demand for the service or product that we have. We think we have a good idea, and we go out there and we just do it. We do it at the wrong location, the wrong point. Is there any major city today that was a major city 3,000 years ago? But yet, we're flocking, as they've done in other periods of history. In Kenya, we flock to Nairobi. And we leave where we were, and we save for jobs and all. I'm here because you've changed your government to a county government. And you have governors in those counties. And if you look at those counties, they've never gotten a fair share of the revenue. You know, I want to sit with governors and major landowners in the county and say, how do we build this into an economically sustainable community? And notice, I didn't say I want to come build a bunch of houses. Is how do you build this into an economically sustainable community? In short, what does this community have? Does it have land? Well, maybe agribusiness is the best thing to do. But not a little plot and you grow enough to feed yourself and a little left over. Agribusiness. You grow enough to feed a bunch of folks for what you're growing. And you don't just grow it, you process it. One of my greatest problems is letting raw materials leave the community. You know, in Kenya, it's coffee. You send coffee out raw. You buy it back processed. How come it didn't get processed here? Those are jobs.
So a developer's responsibility when he looks at a community, when he looks at these counties, is how does it build an economically sustainable community?
Hi there, I'm John Brown. I'm one of the executives at the Bedford Group, an urban infill developer located in Los Angeles that now through the Bedford Group of companies is spreading itself worldwide. The group came to me with the idea that the first trade show would be in Nairobi for East Africa, all the countries that they consider East Africa when you're dividing up Sub-Saharan Africa. And it was chosen because one of the members of the group has experience in doing business there and actually is from there. I didn't realize how great a choice that was till I actually visited. In doing some homework, you believe it was a great choice because of the size and its history and its relationship to the other countries and how stable it was. But once going there and living in the city center for a week and being involved in this event and learning the people, there couldn't been a better place. Not only were the surroundings beautiful, not only were we safe and secure, as a lot of people feared because there's a watch out on traveling in that part of the world, you know, but it was safe, it was beautiful, and the people were just more than I ever expected. This wasn't my first adventure in doing business in Africa. You know, I've worked with some Ghanaians and with several other countries. But the tribal people I met in Kenya, most of them I didn't even learn what tribe they're from. I saw more cooperation there, more team play, more willing to work together. The idea of cooperative economics really in play with small and big businesses. It was just a wealth of good to be there.
There's something in every community that can be converted to resources so that that community is exporting more services and goods than it's spending. You can take that down to a village. What do you have? So if you can build sustainability for yourself, but you can build profit for your community if you send out more than you bring in. I want to be part of building economically strong communities. What creates the most value for the community? We're in a situation where people are first, environment is second, and profit is third. But it doesn't work without balance between all three. So we're trying to connect worldwide with interests in Africa and other places. African Trade Link is here. So you're plugged in, so we're all working on the same page. Where there are resources here that can help resources here, you put them there. Where there's capital here that can help capital here. But it's got to be well thought out. All of us little business people need to get together. In America, 65% of the jobs are not with Fortune 500 companies, they're with small businesses. If Kenya has 60% unemployment, it's not going to come because big corporations come in. It's not going to go down. It's going to be because you entrepreneurs and you smaller business people grow your businesses. You go from one or two employees to 10. Or you go from 30 to 100, or 100 to 500. It's going to grow from you. And some of you will become giant businesses, others will stay small, others will grow. But that's where it's going to come from. This is African Trade Link and Expo. What can I do to help you right now?
We have a system which I'm going to explain to you how we can get it to you, but that system basically starts from the soil to plant to the newest technology to animals to you human being back in the soil without leaving behind any carbon traces. Basically what I'm saying, you can use your land to produce a certain crop. You can manufacture that crop, turn it into ethanol. Give your friends who have cars, rich friends, to use it in their cars. You can take the leftovers, feed your chickens and your pigs, turn it into meat, sell it to Kenya Meat, sell it to your neighbors. Feed some to yourself and be able to export some abroad to the Americans, to the Europeans, to the Russians, to the Chinese.
The solutions are not always coming from government or some business telling the people what it is that they need to do. Really, all we might need to do is free the people enough so that they can find that those solutions are already in them. and that individual responsibility becomes a collective responsibility, becomes a cultural legacy and a social legacy for creating economic justice, something that needs to happen here and something that also needs to happen in Los Angeles.
Africa Trade Link and Expo. I'm the Kenya Logistics Director. And Anne, you have such a beautiful home. Thank you for inviting us here.
Thank you very much, Evelyn.
Yeah.
Welcome to my home.
Thank you.
This is Nairobi. This is Kenya.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Thank you. Come have a look. Yeah.
Where my office is.
Yeah.
I work from my home because I'm a very busy lady.
Yes.
So I can't afford to run up and down.
Yeah.
I've got a young family.
Yeah.
With three children and a husband to take care of.
Yeah.
And I run businesses. Okay?
Yeah.
And at the same time, I'm a politician.
Yes.
And my husband is also a politician. So I can't afford to move it. So this is where my children hang. This is where they do their PlayStation, do their little things here and there. Yeah?
Beautiful.
Yeah?
Look at this.
Mm-hmm.
This is nice.
We also have a good view of the outside.
Yeah.
Yeah?
That's lovely.
Did you see that artwork? I love this
artwork.
This one here.
Oh, this one.
Yeah. This is. Did you see that? Thank you. I've had this for very many years.
Beautiful.
This is Jen. Jen, come and say hi.
Hi, Jen.
Jen
has a big
thank you. My dining room.
Wow.
Where we dine. Mm. Actually, for the family, we're just five of us.
Yeah.
What we do, we try to keep a private life.
Good. Yes.
Because he's a politician, I'm also a politician.
Yeah.
We don't keep bring guests home.
Yeah.
Entertain the hotels.
Yes.
Yeah?
And come home to
so acquire life. This is very, very private, actually.
This is great.
Yeah? Yeah. It's very, very private.
Wow, that was fast. Wow.
Hi.
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 How are you?
Joy.
Joy.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Your house is very beautiful.
It is beautiful.
My goodness.
Thank you.
My name is Anne. This is Anyanga. Anne Anyanga. I have three children, and I'm married to Honorable Anyanga, the MP for Nyantike. I am a member of the Kenya Chamber of Commerce. I met Africa Trade Link through the Kenya Chamber of Commerce. And I was very impressed with the things that I had them say over the 3 days when they had their expo. And I invited them to come to my home so that I could appreciate what they're doing. And at the same time, they get to know how African families live here in Africa. So I thank you very much for having come to Kenya and for having come to my home. I love Kenya very much and I love Nairobi. But the place where my heart is in the village. Deep down in my heart, I'm a social worker and I relate better with the people in the village. I come from a place called Nyantike, which is a semi-arid land. And with semi-arid land, we have regular droughts. Therefore, a lot of times, the people there do not have food. Government has to send them food for them to survive.
And we also have a very big river there called River Kuja. When the rain comes that occasionally, it rains so much and there's a lot of drought. So there is a lot of displacement. So you find ourselves in a scenario where when there's no rain, people are dying of hunger. When there's rain, people are dying of floods and they're being displaced. So those are the challenges we are facing. I love Nyantike because I relate with their problems. And I feel I can do something. And I've spoken to Africa Trade Link a lot. And I've found many solutions to the problems of the people there, where we will be able to work with them, get them to start businesses where they are benefiting, and our brothers and sisters in America are also benefiting. So we are finding a mutual business relationship where it's a win-win situation.
Greetings. My name is Benjamin Walker, Sr. I'm president and CEO of WEI Industries, a California corporation. I'm here in Nairobi, Kenya, with the African Trade Link. And the purpose of the Trade Link is to create an environment where SMEs can partner with other SMEs here in Nairobi. SMEs are the backbone of our economy and the backbone of this economy. That's why I'm here. Specifically, I'm here is because of Power Africa. Power Africa is necessary. Kenya is prime. Kenya's ticket to economic prosperity is the sun. And solar is a key vehicle to utilize the sun for electricity. I am glad to be here in Nairobi. I'm expecting to locate a Kenyan partner here to get involved with the development of solar power, or the further development of solar power here in Kenya. This is my first trip to Kenya. And I had this vision of Kenya before I arrived. I got all these scares from my State Department about the insecurity and this and that, this and that. But I'm a 2-year war veteran. I was in the Vietnam War, so I wasn't worried about that. I just wanted to come over and make sure that I was part of our initial mission, was to create ATL as a vehicle for small and medium-sized businesses to do businesses in Africa. I am very pleased with Kenya. Kenya, to me, is great. I met some fantastic people, and I think most of all, and what's really, really got my attention, but the Kenyans are very polite people. They're very soft-spoken, and they're very respectful, especially when it comes to American bringing them information about various technologies. I was well received at the seminar. I was very well received from the point of view of the questions and answers section. I had 15, 20 people at both sessions who wanted additional information, just basic information about solar. And I was very, 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 very pleased because I located a partner. For all you Americans who have all these ideas about Africa, you need to be here, and I guarantee you will enjoy it. And for African Americans, it's a treat to come here and see us in all walks of life here. What I would like to advise for you to do, because I believe in supporting African business, call Kenyan Airlines and find out how you can get over here at a reasonable rate, and you'll enjoy it. It will be that like we say in America, you know, when you get older, you always have that bucket list. It'll be something that you can complete on your bucket list, and you yourself will be very pleased, like I am.
My name is Evelyn Oyombera. I am the Kenya Logistics Director for Africa Trade Link and Expo. I came down on the ground to help organize the logistics, get the venue and the hotels, make sure that the transportation is all sorted out, and to welcome the incoming guests from America. This is a job I love. I've done it before in my entire life, and I was very thrilled when Africa Trade Link approached me to do what I do today. You know, we were thrilled to have His Excellency, the Kenya Chamber of Commerce and Industry, during the relaunch at the KICC on 25th of July, and the occasion was graced by His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta during the launch of the relaunch of the Kenya Chamber of Commerce. It was an exciting moment for us because then we got to be recognized. The American investors who were on were recognized by the president, and that was a huge thing for us. We were so excited, and I just love, I know we are going places.
My name is Judy Minaj. I'm the executive producer of Africa Trade Link and Expo. Africa Trade Link and Expo basically means connecting small and medium-sized businesses that are in America to those in Africa. And we are in Nairobi right now, connecting with small and medium-sized businesses. The experience is great, the experience is wonderful. And for those who are not able to attend this year's Africa Trade Link and Expo, I expect next year in May you will join us. My company name is Minaj, and we export clothing from America to Africa. And we've been doing the export for the last 2 years, and we are among the few suppliers. I think maybe there's only two suppliers of clothing in Kenya from America that do big distribution, and Minaj is one of them. And a lot of people in Kenya and Africa as a whole love American clothing, and that has become very lucrative business for us. And we had retail stores to where our retail stores in California, the African market actually supporting them more than the retail stores we have in California. So the export business is really booming. I mean, commodities is a big, there's a big need for commodities here in Kenya, from clothing to underwear to handbags to just a lot of other things. Well, I'm a Kenyan. I was born in Kenya and migrated to America 25 years ago, where I became naturalized American citizen. And although it took long for me to come back to Kenya, Kenya is a beautiful country. And what I like most about Kenya is the weather. For those who live in California, you will identify with Kenya very well. Beautiful weather, the sun, the birds, going on safari, seeing the animals. I mean, it's just exciting. And above all, I think the Kenyan people are very, very, very nice people to really associate with or to talk with. They are kind. You can communicate with them in English. And most of them really, they're easy to talk to. For those Americans who haven't been able to come to Africa as a whole, this trip we have a couple of people who had not visited, and I'll assure you they had excellent experience. And initially they were scared, but what I hear from them is they want to come back to Africa. So in itself, that tells me they had a very, very good experience. For those who want to come to Africa, it's not easy to do it by yourself. We encourage you to join our team, Africa Trade Link and Expo, to the next exposition so that you can come. There's many ways you can come. You can come to tour, and then you can also come to do business. So if you're looking just to check it out, you come with Africa Trade Link and Expo. If you're looking to start your own business and partner with the local people so we can empower and grow business on both sides, join Africa Trade Link and Expo.
Greetings, my name is Calvin Kennedy, here with the African Trade Link and Expo, and I'm representing ASAR Economic Development Corporation, which is a civil society organization that we have reimagined and redeveloped its business model out of Los Angeles, California. And what really brings me here is our League of Sustainable Communities. And the idea behind our League of Sustainable Communities is to develop communities around sustainable practices, not just in the green development area, but also in the area of what we call societal practices. One of our partners that was a real driving force for me to be here is one that we call the Collaborative Partnership, AEDC Water for Life. We know that a mobile water purification system is really vital for a place like Africa. In fact, I believe it'll be vital for other places as well, but we really wanted to be part of a movement to help create a new way of life, to create a new currency. So we're here and we've met with, I've met with doctors from, when I say doctors, I mean PhDs. I've met with professors, business people, as well as students, and all of them are very interested in the products that we have. I am also representing ASAR Consulting, and ASAR Consulting is a system integrator, a program project management company, and I also happen to find that there's a market for that here as well. So there's a lot of opportunity here, and one thing that you see here is a lot of people from other parts of the world taking advantage of the opportunity. So it's our goal that small, medium-sized businesses in America and African Americans in particular become aware of the opportunities and become linked with their brothers and sisters on the continent as we help to improve the lives of all of us. Nairobi is such a beautiful place. In fact, where we are right now, if you could just see it, I mean, it's serene and it makes you wanna figure out a way to purchase your real estate here. But the thing that really struck me the most about Kenya and Nairobi are the people. And there's two examples that I like to give that distinguishes the social fabric and the social mechanism of the people. One of them is when we were at the marketplace yesterday, as we were walking in, I noticed that, well, we had some people meet us outside that I thought were maybe, you know, for lack of a better word, bums and beggars. But as we got in and they were walking us around, these were the people that they were taking us to the various vendors. And what we were able to observe essentially is that they had already established relationships with all of these vendors and trust to have us as customers where we could go and negotiate with them on behalf of any vendor in that place. And whatever we did with them was acceptable to the vendors and they worked it out. And it was as if it was all seamless to us. It was as if, you know, we really don't understand how it was working, because something like this I don't think could work in America. The other thing I saw was there was an accident on the way here. And in that accident, I was asking, well, do people have insurance here? Or how do they deal with this? And he said, well, no, they argue and then they agree. And then they have to pay. And I said, well, what makes them pay? They said they'd write the agreement together right there. And I was like, well, who forces them to pay? Because I said that something like that wouldn't work in America. But what that told me was that there is a social cohesiveness that we can learn a lot about. There's a level of trust that we can learn a lot about. And so that was one of the major major points of Kenya for me that really impacted me. For those of you that have not been to Africa or to Kenya, and especially those of you that are of African descent, I feel that you need to come and see for yourself what Africa is, because what is portrayed to you in the media is not true. And I think there's two people on this trip that are here for the first time. And you can just see the feelings and the emotions that they're feeling because they're being around all of these African people. So beyond the beauty of the place, beyond the business opportunities, I think there is something that happens for African Americans and Africans in the diaspora that come home. I think something reconnects and reinvigorates the soul.
Hello, my name is Steve Quincy. I am the CEO of Four Seasons Development Group. We're located in Southern California in the United States. We came to Kenya to the African Trade Link and Expo with several projects seeking investors. And what occurred is that we found that there's a need to invest in both directions. And with that, we were very well welcomed, and we seriously feel as that we are at home. Coming here has been a very great experience. This is my first trip to Africa as well as Kenya. And being here, I feel like I am at home. I love the people, I love the culture, I love the food, and the welcome has been just so great. I really can't emphasize how warm and kind the people are. I would love for my people to come to Africa, to come to Kenya, to find out that everything that you have been told is not true. It's greater than that.
My name is Joy Elliott. I'm the CFO of Four Seasons Development Group. We're a planning and urban development firm, and we're here at the Africa Trade Link and Expo in Nairobi, Kenya. My main reason for coming is to inform everyone about the EB-5 program in the United States. It's a U.S. government program whereby foreigners can invest into U.S. commercial enterprises and receive their green card. I think a lot of Kenyan investors would be interested in this program because it's a way to immigrate to the United States easily and also expand your portfolio. I had an amazing time being in Nairobi. We had a chance to connect with the local people. We went to some villages and we also attended safari, so that was fun. And I would definitely recommend, and when I come back, I will be coming back soon, and I'll definitely be bringing back some people with me and show them the wonderful country of Kenya. One of the main things that I would love to bring back with me is some of my colleagues from the United States. They would have a great time here. The business is ripe. There are a lot of opportunities, and I definitely will be taking this message back when I go back to California.
Greetings. My name is Tyrone Hooks. I am the co-producer of the Africa Trade Link and Expo, taking place right here in the beautiful city of Nairobi, Kenya. The reason I'm here is to develop the seminars, to develop the coordination of the program for the Africa Trade Link and Expo. We are here to meet with small businesses from Kenya and to connect them with small businesses from the United States of America. We are about developing jobs for both sides of the continent, and we feel this is extremely important because without jobs, the quality of life will not progress. My experience in Nairobi has been great. I've been to Nairobi many times, so coming back now with people who are here for the first time is really a wonderful experience because I'm able to talk to them and show them some of the amazing things that I've seen over the times that I've been here. But one thing about it is, when I came this time, I was able to go on a safari. And that was something, was a new experience for me, even though I've been to Kenya many times. But I was able to enjoy the wildlife, to enjoy the opportunity to see other people enjoy it. So that was a great thing for me. Nairobi is, of course, a fantastic city. It's a lot of people here. And that makes it a place where the world goes round. And we want to make sure that we continue to enjoy that cosmopolitan lifestyle. I'm suggesting, I'm advising, I'm asking people who have never been to Kenya before to come and enjoy the environment, enjoy the vibrance of the city and the people. They're welcoming you, and you need to come and join us.
To all Americans, we love you. We love you very much. And we thank you for having thought of Africa. To your America, waruaku, biurulimua, kikulal, wantiere kairiwe yiruaku ukabisa, sasa mubiro, umanyoa, kidwabrubudo koduma ber, wambi kubiro kono wanamanyo, irurukamana inyanya, sae mundo telu. Karibuni Kenya sana, mtafraia sana, asanteni sana. What I said was, welcome to Kenya, you will be happy here. Welcome. Karibuni sana.